living in a society in which there are so many evils, so many sins are taking place, yet we never ponder or we never consider or count them as sins. Accusing others is very common in our society. भाई आपके पास अभी मस्जिद के सफीर आ रहे हैं, आप इस मुबारक दिन के अंदर जो कुछ भी दे सकते हैं अल्लाह की बात को आप शुक्र दें, अल्लाह आपको इस पर दुनिया आखिरत में बता फरमाएं। देख लेते हैं संकेत किस तो के अल्लाह सुभान व तआला अगर वो जो इस दुनिया अंधेरा आप सकते हैं accusation, slandering, backbiting, lying, very common in our society, very common, and yet we do not consider them as sins. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on one occasion he addressed and he asked and he questioned the companions, atadruna mal ghiba, he said to them, do you know the definition of ghiba, backbiting? The companions replied by saying, Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. They said, Allah and his messenger knows best. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then defined and he explained what is riba, what is backbiting. You know, today, you know what we say? Oh, I can say this on his face. If I'm saying behind his back, I can say this on his face. You know, in order to satisfy our own self, you say, I can say on this. If somebody tells you off, don't you know this is backbiting, we can say, we turn around and we say, no, I can say on his face. I can say this on his face. I'm not scared of him. I can say on his face. This is the nafs playing with us. The shaitan is playing with us. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked the companions, what is backbiting? Could you tell me? They said, we don't know. Only Allah or his messenger knows what is backbiting. And then he replied, Rikruka akhaka bima yakrah. He said, the definition of backbiting, ribat, is you make such comment and remarks about your brother, which if he comes to know that you have been making these comments about him, he would dislike it. He would feel. He said, this is the riba and this is the backbiting. Now listen, the next part of the hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked, O Prophet of Allah, what if my comments are right? I am true in making the comments. Say, if I said, he is a liar, so and so is a liar. You're talking, conversation is taking place. And you said, so and so is a liar. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you are true in making your comments about your brother, then this is backbiting. This is backbiting. Month of Ramadan passed by. Just days ago, the month of Ramadan came to an end. Even in the month of Ramadan, I assume this sin was taking place. While we were fasting, this sin was taking place. While we were fasting, we were slandering others. While we were fasting, we were lying. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, the comments you made, if these comments were found in this brother, then this is ghibat. And if you were found telling a lie against your brother and the comments you made, he did not possess those comments. He did not possess those qualities which you mentioned about him. then you have slandered him. Then you have accused him. Then you have accused him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith, in another hadith, he says, when a believer in a majlis, in a gathering, he is being backbited, and another Muslim is listening and he is there and he is present, and yet he does not defend his brother. A Muslim is being backbited and he is, you know, bad comments are being made about him, and other Muslims or brothers are sitting and listening, and yet they are not defending the one who is not present there. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, these very Muslims or these very brothers or the individual who was listening to the comments, and yet he did not defend his brother. A time Allah will bring, I address myself and then you, a time Allah will bring when you will be in a severe need, you will be in a severe help, you would want someone to help you, Allah Almighty will withhold his help from you. Allah Almighty will not assist you. Allah will not assist you. Why? Because there was a time and occasion came when a Muslim brother needed your help while he was not there, he was not present, and you were making comment about him, and he was being slandered, and you were being cheerful and happy. Yes, good, good, carry on, carry on, carry on making these comments about him. You know, you become very cheerful, you know, you become very pleased. Oh, that's good, it's happening. Oh, mashallah, this is more Riaz is being talked about. Now, let's pass on this now. Let's pass on now. It's in the member talks. Let's pass on this accusation to others. Yet is talaqawnahu bi alsinatikum. Allah Almighty is saying, and Allah is alerting us. Allah is, when you spread a rumor with your tongues or through your messages, normal messages on WhatsApp or whatever, and then Allah, وَتَكُولُونَ بِأَفْوَاهِكُمْ مَا لَيْسَ لَكُمْ بِهِمْ. Allah is saying, then you begin to say with your tongues, then you begin to start sending the messages on your WhatsApp groups, while you do not have any knowledge about the comments and about the accusation, whether this accusation is true or not true. You just go ahead and you think, وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ حَيِّنَا. Allah is alerting us. You consider and you count it as a very light thing and very little thing. You think this is nothing. Allah is وَهُوَ إِنَّ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. That thing you've considered very light, very little, in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is very big. Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala addressed Ka'batullah. You know what he said? He said, oh Ka'bah, I know your sanctity is very high in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But I can tell you now, oh Ka'batullah, every brick of yours is very sacred in the eyes of Allah. But I can tell you, the sanctity of a believer in the sight of Allah is much higher than your sanctity. And yet we think, my prayer, you know, on the day of judgment, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do you know who is a bankrupt person? Who is a penniless person? You know, they said, to us, penniless person is the one who has, you know, who has nothing, a bankrupt person, who has nothing left. With him, there is nothing. He's a penniless person. He's got no money, no money, nothing, no wealth. He said, no, this is a penniless person. A true penniless and bankrupt person of my ummah, my follower, is the one who offered the prayers, recited the Quran, did all the good deeds. Along with his good deeds, an occasion came, a time came, he swore at someone. A time came, he accused someone. A time came, he backbited someone. There's a hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. On the day of his judgment, Abu Burayda radiallahu ta'ala, he narrates the hadith. On the day of his judgment, a man, his book of deeds will be opened in front of him. And he will, Allah will say, Ikra kitaba, you read your book yourself today, what you have done in the dunya. He will start reading the book. All the amals which he did in dunya will be written in his book. And then he will say to Allah, you know what he said? He will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, oh, Ya Rabbi, fa'ina al-hasanatu kada wa kada, wa amiltuha, And they are not, oh Allah, there are deeds which I did in dunya, but I cannot see them here. Oh Allah, you are just. You're going to do any injustice to anyone. Oh Allah, where are my deeds gone? The book shows me these deeds are not there. Your angels have did injustice to me. They have been unjust to me. They have not wrote the deeds in the book of deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no. My angels wrote everything what you did. They wrote everything. You know something? You know you think only the angels are writing. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set up a secret police for us. You know your own limbs. These limbs are recording. When you stretch your hands towards something, the hand records what you are stretching the hand towards. You know, when you're talking, your tongue records. You know, when you're seeing something, your eyes record it. You know, your feet record everything. This is the secret police of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, the part of the earth where you're standing, that very part is recording what you're doing. Whatever you're doing is being recorded. The angels are writing it down. And they say to Allah, oh Allah, oh my Lord, where are the good deeds gone? You are just, your angels are just, where have they gone? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that's true. You've did it. I say that you did the good deeds and they were written in the book. So where have they gone? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, we wrote them. But you've been backbiting. Whenever you backbited a brother, then we deleted from the book of deeds. We wiped it off. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, on the day of judgment, the penniless, the one who did everything, and yet he accused someone, and yet he swore at someone, he backbited, then all his good deeds, they will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need justice. We want justice from you, Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he, Allah Almighty, will give his deeds. He struggled, he strived to do all the good deeds, yet on the day of judgment, all the deeds will go to that person whom he accused. And also today, lying, very common. We think when somebody comes to tell you something, you pass it on. Somebody sent you a message, you pass it on. You think this is not a lie. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, it is enough to make a believer a liar just to convey and pass on whatever he hears. Any message came, let's pass it on. Let's pass it on to the other group. This is enough to make you a liar. And a liar cannot be a bold, trusty person. You cannot trust him. He's a trustworthy person. You cannot trust him. Even if he, it's not his habit to lie. But when he conveys the messages about which he does not know whether they are true or not, and he just passes on, he is a liar in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَكْفُوا مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِمْ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلْ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْئُولًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not follow of that which you have no knowledge, which means don't say something that you have no knowledge of. Don't make a comment of which you have no knowledge. Don't say about another brother about whom you don't know. Somebody accused him and you started spreading that accusation in the community. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, remember the hearing, the sight, the ears, everything about which you will be asked on the day of judgment. You will be asked on the day of your ears will speak. Al-yawma nakhtimu ala afwahihim wa tukallimuna aydihim wa tashhadu arjuluhum bima kanu yaksibun. Our limbs will speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our hands will speak. Our feet will speak. Our every limb and every hair of the body will speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either it will testify in our favor or against us. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me and you the tawfiq to refrain from these sins, backbiting, lying, accusing others, or spreading accusation in the community. You know, you think you're offering the prayers and you're everything. You're not everything until you refrain from these sins which I have mentioned in my talk. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept others sitting here. Jumay ki namaz se pehle ye elan simaat firma le. Haji Ghulam Ahmed Marhoom, jo aap ki is masjid ke trustee nahi.